I've asked Merveli to make me a advertensie te maak. En ek weet nie wat die tema vir die preek nie. Toe sê ek, Martha, Martha. Maar ek weet waartoe ek vanoggend wil gaan. Die vraag is, Mike, iewers staan daai ding van Martha, Martha. So those of you who can complete the verse, you can stand and go to the cafeteria. The rest remain behind for the service. Right. Wie het projekte by die huis? Moenie hand opsteek nie. Projekte by die huis wat onafgehandel is. Jy het begin, maar is nie klaar nie. Darren, I know you are one of them. Ok, ons het begin, maar ons is nie klaar nie. Ons wou die stoor reg gepak het, die rok se soem, one of the walls on the in the rooms, die boek wat half geskryf is, gordyne wat nie klaar gehang is nie, dis al dae uitstaande, van dit maande, en van dit al jare. So die vraag is, hoekom? So seker is daar baie redes. Een is, ek was besig met die projek te word donker. That's a good one. Ek het uit tyd gehardloop. Die ander een is, ek het uit geld uit geraak. En is seker waar. Maar, intussen het die son weer opgekom. Intussen het ek weer finansies gekry. So daai verskoning is lank nie meer geldig nie. Ek dink, my aandag is afgelei na iets anders. Ek het fokus verloor. I got distracted. I was busy with this, and now I'm busy with that. I lost focus. Iets anders het belangriker geraak as waarmee ek besig was. Ons dis presies wat die vyand met my en jou doen. Wie van ons kan nog vir Rambo onthou? Ok, right. Daar was 5 van hulle. Ek bedoel 5 of meer series. Dieselfde soos Rocky, nee. Ok. Right, Rambo. Dan loop hy verby manne by 'n hek. Gewapende mans wat met guns staan en die hek bewapen. Dan loop hy met 'n mes en 'n kopband. Dan vat hy 'n klippie, dan gooi hy 'n klippie teen 'n ruit. So wat doen die wagte met die wapens? Hulle kyk soontoe en Rambo stap agter hulle rug verby. Hoe het hy dit reg gekry? Hy het hulle distract met 'n klein dingetjie, met 'n klein klippie. Anders dit gebeur met my en jou. Die vyand distract ons met ietsie klein van dit waarmee die Here eintlik met ons op pad is. Distracted beteken eintlik pulled away, dragged away, weggetrek. If I'm correct, we have 5 months left for the rest of the year. And I'm sure and I know in the beginning of the year, some of us had New Year's resolutions. So the question is, are we still busy with him? Or did we get distracted? Maybe you had for your health, Gerald, ons gaan 'n bietjie gym toe, parkrun, walking, whatever. For your marriage, Derek, ons gaan oorslaap met ons wedding anniversary. Flowers once a month. Dis mos wat hy gesê het. Or your children. I'll go watch their sports. I'll pray with them once a week. Or your finances. You said the beginning of a year. This year, I'll start to tithe. This year, I'm attending cell. kom nou by hom. I'll start saving by die finansies. Spiritually, het jy vir jouself gesê, I'll get baptized this year. Of ek gaan my Bybel begin lees. I'll be committed to sell. So what happened to all the above? I think we got distracted. No focus. All of the above was important. Nee, excuse, kom ek sê eerder. If all of the above was important to you, you would have focused on it. Everything else wasn't that important. When something is important, you often think of it a lot. Maak dit sin? As iets belangrik is, dan dink ons oor dit. As my vrou dorp toe gaan, regtig, en sy kom terug van Pick n Pay af, dan bring sy vir my chocolate. Dan sê ek, ag Gees, dankie my engel. Dan sê sy, ek het aan jou gedink. Dan gaan ek Pick n Pay toe. Ek het nog nie klaar gepraat nie. Derek, ek wou sê, dan kom ek met 'n bos blomme terug. Nee, dan gaan ek Pick n Pay toe. Dan, en dan kom by die huis. Dan sê sy, het jy vir my iets gebring? Dan staan ek daar met leë hande. Dan sê sy, jy het nie aan my gedink nie. As it's true, if something is important to you, you will spend time with it and you will think of it often. Ek dink as 'n ek moet hom nou net reg hê. Where the attention goes, the power flows. Is dit hoe hy gaan? Where the attention goes, the power flows. John 5:19. Is Jesus, he said this. He says, truly, truly, I say to you, the Son, this is not hy, can do nothing out of his own accord, but only what he sees the Father doing. Whatever the Father does, the Son does likewise. Hierso het ons iemand, Jesus, wat gefokus was op dit wat sy, wat die Vader vir hom sê. Ek doe net een ding. Weet, ons wil te veel dinge op een slag doen. Daar's 'n gesegde wat sê, jy kan nie twee hase jag nie. As jy twee hase jag, hoeveel vang jy? Nie een nie. Want jy hol rond agter al twee aan. Weet, ons wil multitask. Miskien kry die vrouens meer uitgerig as die mans, maar ons kan nie, ons sukkel. Fokus op een ding. Jesus het gefokus op dit wat die Vader vir hom sê om te doen. Dankie, Jaco. Ek het hierdie storie al vertel. Maar kom ons vertel hom weer. Hierdie koning ry deur die woud en hy kom by die village. He arrives at the village. And he said to the people in the village, who is this perfect, good archer you've got in this village? He must be excellent. Because while I was riding to this village, I saw all these arrows in the tree where this archer has practiced. So they told him, no, it's the town idiot. He's just shooting, hit and hope, he's just shooting, and if he hits a tree, he draws a circle. Ouens, kom ons wees nie so nie. Julle weet van hit and hope. Ek dink 'n golfer ken van hit and hope. Kom ons wees nie so nie, maar wees gefokus. Aim for something. Focus. Ek kyk al vir Mike. I know, a golfer, surely a golfer, is aiming at the flag. He don't always hit the green, but he's aiming for something. So he focused before he hit the ball. Our scripture this morning is Luke 3. Kan ons daar lees, is hy te klein? Luke 10:38. And that's the story about Martha and Mary. Martha, Martha. It says, verse 38, he says, now as they went on their way, Jesus entered a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. Ek het 'n paar goed ge-highlight, en dis die paar goedjies waaroor ons vanoggend wil gesels. So Martha welcomed him into her home. And she had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. But Martha was distracted with much serving. And she went to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to help me. But the Lord answered her, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things, but one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen the good portion which will not be taken away from her. So my translation in short is, Martha, Martha, what are you focusing on? Focus on me. There's another verse in Matthew 6, 24 and 25, wat 'n soortgelyke story vertel. Dieselfde woorde word daar gebruik. Waaroor kwel jy jou? Die Engels sê, don't be anxious. En dan sê hy, moenie bekommerd wees nie, ek sal vir jou sorg. Keep your focus on me. Het maak nie saak hoe dit om ons lyk nie, of wat rondom ons gebeur nie. We know the saying, it's not what happens around you, it's what happens within you. Martha was distracted. She was focusing on a lot of other things with much serving. Maria was gefokus om by Jesus se voete te sit. Ek lees hierdie storie. While crossing the US-Mexican border on his bicycle, Pedro Gonzalez was stopped by the border guard who pointed to the two sacks, backpacks, nee, Pedro had on his shoulders. What's in the bag? Asked the guard. Building sand, Pedro said. Get them off. We'll take a look, said the guard. Pedro did as he was told. And sure enough, in the bags was building sand. You can go. So Pedro carefully scooped up the sand with his hand, reloaded it into the backpack. Putting them on the back of his shoulders, Pedro continued across the border. So this story continues for 6 months. Once a week, Pedro went to the border, sand in his bag. After 6 months, it stopped. One day, the guard was in the market at town, and he recognizes Pedro. Hey, Pedro, long time no see. I knew you were smuggling something across the border. I just didn't know what. And a big grin was on Pedro's face. Bicycles. So the guard had his eyes on the wrong things. He thought he's going to get cocaine and ek weet nie wat alles in the building sand. So his focus was on the backpacks Pedro was carrying. If he had focused on what Pedro was riding, he could have seen that it was a different bicycle every time. But he focused on the wrong things. So waarop fokus ek en jy? Is ons aandag of ons gedagtes op dit wat die Here wil hê ons moet doen, op God se plan vir jou lewe? Of het die vyand ons al verblind? Jy doen nie meer wat die Here wil hê jy moet doen nie. En jy kom dit nie eens meer agter nie en jy is tevrede daarmee. There's a lot of examples in the Bible, the same as Martha and Mary. Some who focused on God and some who lost focus. Some who got distracted. So those who lost focus, David, he focused on Bathsheba. Is it mos nee? Right. Solomon, Samson focused on women. Judas, his focus was on money. Peter, he was scared of persecution. He denied Jesus. Saul, jealousy. Martha, complaining. Lot's wife, on the past. And this is only a few, and I'm sure there are a lot of more examples in the Bible of persons who lost focus. Those who kept their eyes on the Lord, who stayed focused, Moses, uit God vertrou vir voorsiening. Esther, vir die plan vir haar lewe. Paulus, hy het geweet hy moet voor die keiser verskyn. Ongeag die storms om hom, ongeag van 'n slang wat hom byt, hy het geweet hy gaan nie dood nie, want hy moet voor die keiser verskyn. Nehemia, ten spyte van oorlog rondom hom, aanhou bou. En dan Jesus, wat net doen wat die Vader vir hom sê om te doen. Fokus gaan hand aan hand met keuses. En keuses het gevolge. Pastor Thomas. Fokus gaan hand aan hand met keuses en keuses het gevolge. Die Engels sê, choices have consequences. Nou, al hierdie bogenoemdes wat ons genoem het, goed of sleg, het gevolge gehad. En het is vandag nog waar. Kan ek vir ons lees hierso? Deuteronomium 30 vers 19. I call heaven and earth to witness against you. To witness against you today that I have set before you life and death, blessing and curse. Daar's twee. Nou altyd gewoonlik as daar twee goed is, het ek 'n keuse. I give to you blessing and curse. But he gives the answer. Therefore, choose life that you and your offspring may live. Die Afrikaans sê, kies dan lewe, dat jy kan lewe, jy en jou nageslag. Lukas 10:38 sê, Now as they went on their way, this Jesus and his disciples. Jesus entered a village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. Dis Martha wat vir Jesus innooi. Maar sy is te besig in haar eie huis, dat sy nie tyd spandeer met die gas wat sy genooi het nie. En dink bietjie aan jouself. En ek dink ook daaroor, die een wat hom innooi, is die een wat kla. Weet, ek het al baie keer mense genooi, dan sê ek vir my vrou, hierdie mense nooi ek nooit weer nie. Dan sê sy, maar jy het hulle genooi. Of hulle kuier tot die, wat is dit, totdat iemand die ligte afsit, nee, julle weet mos hy, julle sê mos vir die mense, as jy uitgaan sit net die ligte af. Dan sê ek vir my vrou, ja, hierdie mense het lank gekuier vanaand. Dan sê sy, jy het hulle genooi. Ons, Martha nooi vir Jesus in, maar sy is die een wat kla. Ons nooi vir Jesus in ons lewens in, maar ons is te besig. Ek spandeer nie tyd met hom nie. En dan aan die einde van die dag sê ek, Heer, waar is hy? Dan kla ons soos Martha, ons het nie genoeg tyd nie. Ek moet kerk toe gaan. is alweer self vanaand. Ek en jy het self besluit om Jesus in te nooi. So, ek kan nie vir my vrou sê, ek moet vanaand self toe gaan nie. Because I invited Jesus into my life. And I want to go to self. I want to serve Him. I want to praise Him. I want to be here this morning. Amen. Dit was my keuse. Dis nie dat ons die tyd het nie. En dis nie dat Jesus ons verlaat het nie. Dis ons wat fokus verloor het. 39 says, and she had a sister called Mary who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. Who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. Romeine 10 vers 17 sê, geloof is uit die gehoor en die gehoor is deur die woord van God. Faith comes by hearing. She spent time at the feet of Jesus. And I think that is the major difference between these two. Because Mary sat and listened. And let me ask this question. And you know when I ask a question, please don't put up your hand. But answer to yourself honestly. Who spends time in the morning at the feet of Jesus? Okay, nou hier, ek sien die hande, baie dankie, ek sien het. Who's taking their phone along? Okay, nou, Pastor Marcel, ek het hier aan 'n woord gedink, is dit 'n focus shifter? Is that a good word? Is that two words? I thought of two words. Focus shifter. Okay. Ek dink 'n selfoon is 'n focus shifter. Who then reads Bible in the morning? After you read the Bible, who prays? So I think on these questions, most of us has put up our hand. But here's the million-dollar question. Who listens? After you've prayed, after you read your Bible, worship music soft in the room, spend time with the Lord, who spend time to listen? Because most of us, after praying, reading Bible, we get up and we start our day. If I want a breakthrough, or if I have a problem, financial, marriage, at the work, whatever, if we spend time with the Lord, and really focus on God and listen, you will hear the answer to the solution. He will guide you in that situation. Our problem is, you know, they call us microwave Christians. You go in the living room, nice and quiet, 5 minutes, read the Bible, pray, and that's that. We don't spend time to listen. Ons spandeer nie tyd om by Jesus se voete te sit en te luister nie. Daar's 'n vers wat sê, hulle wat op die Here wag, kry nuwe krag. Those who wait upon the Lord will be strengthened. Ek hoor hierdie storie van 'n violinist, violis, wat briljante violis was. And they asked him what the secret was of being such a great violinist. So he said, many things is demanding my time. After I had breakfast, I made my bed, cleaned the rooms, doing what seems necessary. When I finished work, I started to practice the violin. That system prevented me to accomplish what the Lord intended for me. So I reversed things. So my woorde is, I refocused. I deliberately plan to neglect everything else until I finished practicing the violin. So wat sê hierdie ou eintlik? I changed my focus. In plaas daarvan dat ek in die oggende eers bed opmaak en kos maak en huis skoon maak, begin ek met die viool. Daarna, as ek klaar viool geoefen het, is that not a good example for our Christian life? Start first thing in the morning. Focus on the Lord in the morning. Want as ons dag eers aan gegaan het, kom ons nie daarby uit nie. Focus is just a small change with big rewards. Die meeste van ons, en toe ek skryf hierso toe die meeste van ons, toe dink ek by myself, oordryf ek nie, want ek was ook daar, is te besig in die oggende met ander dinge, en dan wil ons later met die Here tyd spandeer, en het werk nie, want ons raak distracted. Ruil jou dag om. Daar's 'n vers wat sê, soek allereers die koninkryk van God, en dan sal al die goedjies wat boek dan dit genoem is, in vervulling kom. Onthou Martha en Maria. Jesus was fisies daar. Daar was nie 'n Heilige Gees nie. Hy was fisies by hulle. En sy kies om huis skoon te maak, en die sissie kies om by Jesus se voete te sit. En as Jesus geloop het, was hy weg. Luke 10:40. But Martha was distracted with much serving. Onthou wat is die woord distracted? She was pulled away. She was dragged away. Wie weet, om by Jesus se voete te sit, is amazing. Hallo? Ons het dit vanoggend hier ervaar met die worship. Nothing compares to it. Jy wil nie eens aantrek en werk toe gaan nie. Jy wil heeltyd in daai salwing bly. Maar, dis ook scary. Hoekom sê ek, why do I say it's scary? Because he knows everything. Hier sit ek voor hom. In die oggend. And I know there's nothing that I can hide from him in the morning. Niks wegsteek nie. Hy weet alles. Ken jou hart. Ken jou gedagtes. Weet wat jy dink terwyl jy daar sit. En dis Maria. So waar's Martha? The busybody. En sy beroof haarself om te besig te wees en nie tyd by die Here se voete te spandeer nie. Ons het ons al gesien. Jy hou jouself besig. Darren, forgive me. But when the Holy Spirit is moving, sometimes we can't handle it. It gets too hot. I start making notes. I go put on the kettle. I take the boys out to the toilet. Want het raak te warm. Enjoy the moment while the Holy Spirit is there among us, in die sel. Hier, vanoggend, daar was 'n oomblik hier wat ek vanoggend ervaar het, die Heilige Gees is regtig hier. Amen. Who knows that things, when things are not going your way, not how you want it to be, things out of our comfort zone, we start complaining and blame shifting. Verse 40. And she went up to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? The answer to that, Lord, do you not care? The answer is yes, he cares. He cares so much that he died on a cross for our sins. He says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So he cares. So she asks, Lord, do you not care? So this is the kind of question we ask when our focus is on the wrong place and on the wrong things and not on the Lord. We say, Lord, where are you? Lord, you don't understand. Lord, don't you see me? We say things like, He will do it to another, but not to me. Have you forgotten about me? Ek is duidelik nie die wit broodjie nie. So what happens next? When we lose our focus on the Lord, we start to focus on people. Ons hoor wat ek vandag vir jou sê. As ons nie op die Here fokus nie, fokus op ons mense. So sy sê iets soos, ek doen ten minste iets, wat doen sy? We take our frustration out on people, on everybody and anybody. She says, tell her to help me. So I now start tasking the Lord. I'm telling the Lord what to do. I'm commanding Him. And that's dangerous. We get into self-pity. Selfbejammering, nee, die arme ek. Verse 41. But the Lord answered her. En hier kom ons by ons tema. Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. Nie een ding nie, nie twee nie, nie drie nie, many things. So ek weet, hier is vanoggend mense met baie bekommernisse. Dit is so. Ek dink dis die menslike natuur. Ons bekommer ons oor goed. Maar luister wat sê Matthew 6:25. Matthew 6:25, it says, do not, dis Jesus wat hy praat. Hy sê, therefore I tell you, do not be anxious. Moet jou nie bekommer nie. About your life, what you will eat, what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more important than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap, nor gather it in barns. Yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not more value than they? And which of you, by being anxious, wie van julle wat worry, can add a single hour to his span of life? And why are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. Neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, kom ons gaan na vers 31 toe. Therefore, do not be anxious. Vers 34. Therefore, do not be anxious. For tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Ek dink is vier keer hierso wat die Here sê, do not be anxious. Moenie worry nie. Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. Die Here ken ons bekommernisse. Hy noem haar naam twee keer. Nou, dit is interessant. Nou vraag ek vir myself, hoekom twee keer? Nou, ek dink, as jy iemand se naam twee keer noem, dan het jy seker sy aandag gekry. Weet, as jou vrou jou twee keer roep, dan moes jy die eerste keer al geantwoord het. So, as jou vrou jou twee keer roep, dan het sy jou aandag. So, hy wil haar aandag kry, hy roep haar naam twee keer, en hy weet, sy is besorg oor baie dinge, en hy het compassie vir haar. Vers 42, but one thing, daar staan nie, a lot of things, or few things, daar staan one thing. So in fact, if it says one thing, I don't have a choice. One thing is necessary. Mary has chosen the good portion, which will not be taken away from her. You are troubled about many things, but one thing. You have lost focus. Stop complaining. Focus on me. Slow down. Ons ken daai gesegde van die rat race. Daai ons hardloop, ons gaan, wat is hy hierdie hamster op daai wielietjies? Daai ding word so moeg, nê, maar hy gaan nêrens heen nie. That's our life. Ons hardloop so rond en ons doen te ons maak soos Martha. Ons wil soveel goed vir die Here doen. Maar ons kom nie by die Here uit nie. Kan ek die band vra om vir ons vorentoe te kom? Ek lees hierdie story van baseballspelers Yogi Berra en Hank Aaron. Two different teams, the New York Yankees and the Milwaukee Braves. So Aaron was the pinch hitter, or the, what's it, the power hitter, and Yogi, the catcher. So dis noem ons daai ou so masker op sy gesig met so verskriklike groot handskoene en 'n bors beskermstut hier op hom. Want daai manne gooi mos verskriklik hard. It is the World Series final. So as Aaron came up to bat, Yogi tried to distract Aaron by saying, ek weet nie wie van julle het al ooit cricket gespeel nie, Marcel. Die wicketkeeper chirp die batsman. Want die wicketkeeper sê vir die batsman, my sussie het so bat. Of jy moet jou bat omdraai. Jy weet, so jy probeer om ons bietjie distract. So Yogi chirped him. He said, you're holding the bat the wrong way. You are supposed to hold it so you can read the trademark. So jy moet jou bat vashou sodat jy kan lees wat daar staan. Aaron didn't say anything. When the next pitch came, he hit a home run. After rounding all the bases and tagging the home, the base plate, Aaron looked at Yogi and said, I didn't come here to read. So he was focused on the ball, not on the trademark. So my vraag vanoggend vir ons hier is, waarop fokus ons? Of het ons fokus verloor? I started the year good, but got distracted. I started the year by focusing. I lost focus. There's one cure. One cure, refocus. Put your focus on the Lord. Do not, when Rambo throws a stone against the wall, get distracted. Or, like the town idiot, circle, waar lees ek vandag? I want to encourage you to be like the violinist. Start your morning at the feet of Jesus. Be like Aaron. Focus on Jesus. Be like Mary. Sit at Jesus' feet and listen. So this morning, I've put my name there. Gerard. And I want you to put your name there. Derek, Derek. Skalk, Skalk. Frans. Put your name there. So the Lord is asking you this morning, waarmee is jy besig? Maybe the Lord is telling you this morning, Karel, Karel, jy hou jouself besig met 'n klomp goed. Kom sit by my voete. I want to ask you this morning, and I know, miskien kan die worship team ons net help, just to play something soft for us. As jy daar is vir oggend, you used to sit at Jesus' feet. You used to read Bible. You used to pray. Maar ek doen dit nie meer nie. I got distracted. Something more is important than what I used to do. Ek wil volgende vir jou vra. Kom vorentoe. Moenie skaam wees nie. Die woord sê, as jy vir my skaam is, gaan ek vir jou skaam wees eendag voor die Vader. Dis wat Jesus sê. I want to encourage you this morning. If the Lord is calling you by name this morning, Darren, Darren, with what are you busy? And the Lord is convicting you this morning. Give us 5 minutes, the service is finished. Give us 5 minutes. Kom vanoggend vorentoe en sê, Lord, here I am. I've lost focus. I was distracted by a small thing. This morning, I want to recommit. I want to recommit. Ek wil weer op U fokus, Vader. If it's you this morning, ek wil jou uitdaag. Vat die boldness, vat die courage, kom vorentoe. Ek het dit ook gedoen. Ons, believe me, I've lost focus a lot of times. A lot of times. But it's worthwhile. It's worthwhile to focus on the Lord. You've got a choice. You've got a choice. And choices have consequences. Daar's die hemel en daar's die hel. You've got a choice. Amen.